Hello, my good friends. How are you today? My name is Tamir, and this is my review on the Austrian Grand. I suppose it's the Bösendorfer that made in Vienna. The Vienna Grand, the Austrian Grand. It's the same one. And I bought this VST piano, grand piano, 2 days ago, 3 days ago, at $50. It's on sale now, so if you like it, go and buy it, because you will hear a beautiful piano. I love the Bösendorfer. I used to have a Yamaha CLP 535, and it's got the CFX and the Bösendorfer, and I usually played the Bösendorfer sound and not the CFX, so I got a attachment to this piano from the past, but let's hear it. Let's hear it. So this is the basic. This is the basic dry. This is. I'm sorry. Sometimes the mic is cutting off. This is the basic dry. The dry sound. So this piano have a 3-microphone setup. The close mic, it's now on. The cinematic mic, it's a little bit further from the piano, and you've got the ambience of the room with them, and the mono mic. Let's hear them, each one. This was the close. Let's hear the cinematic. Again, let's hear the close one. Little bit less ambient, less noisier. Again, the cinematic alone. Okay, so let's put them all together. Ah, let's hear the mono one. It sounds like a transistor. And the velocity curve, I put it a little bit on the hard side. And together, let's hear them all. Okay, you can hear the sound. I wanted you to hear the sound because there are some presets here. We will play with some of them later, but the most important thing is the dry piano, okay? So when you are getting in this fader icon, you can modify a little bit of the sound of the piano, add effects, filters, and everything. This one I use, it's the release time, the R. So it will sound like a piano and not like a synthesizer. Listen here. It's too fast. Usually the gospel pianos like it like this, but I like it more natural way. The color here making the piano bright or mellow to your taste and needs. The pitch, I don't use it making some weird things. A tremolo, vibrato, it's not very effective to a piano, I think. So I don't use them anyway. And that's all. You can play with it if you want it. I don't use all of these filters and anything. The polyphonic, I usually put it on 88, and at the default it's come on 64. It's enough for a basic piano, but if you've got the juice on your computer, so why not? Okay, and the last and not least, the effects you can add here. Reverbs, flangers, spark verbs. Some kinds of reverbs and delays and things like that. And you can get to more deep section of effects here on the upper side of the windows. So you can hear it. Convoler, you can see here many options. And that's it. And you've got an arpeggiator. I never use an arpeggiator. And you can... you can use some presets, but I don't see it effective to me anyway. This is the piano. I love it just for the sound of the Bösendorfer. Beautiful sound. Let's go over some of the presets so you can hear them. This is the basic dry. Let's go to the basic hall. The basic hall will open the ambience mic and the mono. As you can see here, the cinematic, I'm sorry, it's the same. Cinematic microphones and the mono microphone, and it will disable the closed microphone. Hear it. It's more suitable to a classical pianist. It gives you the short version. Last but not least. Okay, I think you've got it all. I love this piano. It's new, so I'm playing it a lot. I've got here also, I got it free with my hardware Atom SQ what's the name? Presonus, yes, Presonus. So I bought it from my Studio One, and in the packages that you've got with this hardware, you've got the grand piano model. This will be my next review. I will give you to hear it dry. Of course, Model D is the famous piano of Steinway, the concert piano, the concert grand piano of Steinway. The next review will be on it. I hope you will. If you like pianos like me, register to my channel. There is a personal adventure for me to look for acoustic upright. And I will do this journey with you, my subscribers, and we will see together how good used piano, upright used piano, we can find here in Israel. So stay in touch. This will be my first personal acoustic piano, because till now, my history is that I, as a child, played with organs, and then when, as a teenager, I used some, let's go back to the original. I used to play on arranger keyboards, like all the hobbyist keyboardists in the 90s. And anyway, 7 years ago, I bought my first piano. It's the Yamaha, the CLP-535. And I fell in love with the touch, with everything, with playing one instrument and not the band, digitized band. So I dedicated my, let's say my, I don't say my life, but my passion, my hobby, only to the piano. So I started with the Yamaha, I went to the Roland, now I'm with the Kawai, now I'm trying some VSTs of famous grands that I never played before. But after I played, and my why upright, not just the money, I'm looking for upright with the training pedal, with the soft sound, you know, the how they call it, the felt between the hammers. Usually all the Yamaha pianos and Kawai pianos without any silent or digital sound of any sorts, if it's pure acoustic, usually these brands have the middle pedal. You can push it down on the left and you've got this felt going down between the hammers and the strings, and it making the piano soft, and this is what I like, soft pianos. So have a nice day. See you at the next one. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, and I will see you soon. Thank you. And bye.